Okay, thank you. My name is Christian Ottermann from Germany, from 52 North Degree in Münster, 52 degrees north in Münster, and I want to talk about the SWE ingestion service of the Data Cloud project and how it can facilitate the publication of real-time marine observation data. First of all, it's a short introduction to SensorWeb because not everybody may be familiar with it. In the classical setup, in the classical GIS setup, we have different observation networks or the data silos or something which has data and different kind of clients, and these may be GIS system, classical desktop GIS system, or web clients, or any other system. And in the classical approach, we have to build adapters or brokers or something else to access these systems, and we have to develop it every time again. For this, the OGC specified a suite of standards called the SensorWeb standards, which include the ONM standard, observations measurements, which is a standard to encode data or measurements, the SensorML standard to encode descriptions of sensors or networks of sensors or observatories, and the sensor observation service, which is kind of an access interface to access data, to query data, to download data. There are some more standards in this suite. For example, there are standards for event detection, for notification, or for planning of sensing. But in this presentation, we will focus on the SOS and the ONM part, and of course, the SensorML part. But there are quite a few other. So the SWE ingestion service of the C Data Cloud project aims to facilitate the publication of observation data or observation data streams. This means unvalidated near real-time or real-time data. Not that what you know from the C Data Cloud project or C DataNet project, validated archive data, but really real-time data, operational marine data. It will be operated under the PI of the observatories, so there's no centralized instance, but everybody can ingest their own data. And you can link from the CDI back to the live data. So if you have a data set in the CDI, which is quality controlled and archived and so on, but you want to provide the users with a more live data, so the measurement from an hour ago, so you can link back from the CDI to the live data. Also, you can enhance the metadata which is in the CDI with the metadata that is encoded in SensorML, so you can really have detailed description of sensors. These descriptions are encoded in SensorML, and we're using it to receive the data, to decode the data, and also to check the data. And as said, we want to enrich the CDI metadata with that metadata. We had a couple of use cases for this. So the data can be produced in different ways. We have the Nexos SAISI platforms, for example, which can push directly to sensor observation services, which were kind of working already, so we didn't look at that. But we looked at platforms that upload files to FTP servers or publish the data via MQTT or something like that. So we can pull data from from FTP services or SFTP services or you name it, and we can handle data that is pushed to us via different messaging services, for example. This data is then published in an SOS service instance and can be, again, linked from the CDI. For this, we developed this kind of infrastructure. The very base is the Spring. We are using the Spring Cloud Data Flow Server, which is, well, a Java Spring application server, which can deploy different syncs, sources, and processors that you can plug in each other and can direct data flow through a system. And we implemented a few sources, syncs, and processors for that. We had two main use cases in this example. One is the MQTT server from the Marine Institute, which produces, I think, every second a few data points. We are feeding these into an MQTT source and processing it via a processor, in this case a CSV processor, which parses the data, creates observations from it, and dumps it into a Postgres database. Another use case was an FTP server, which has also CSV files on it, which are updated regularly, or there are new files on the FTP server. And we are pulling them in a regular interval and pushing them through the same processors and sinks and so on to get them to the SOS instance. The SOS is reading from this Postgres database, and we are displaying it via a generic client, in this case Helvoland, which is our SOS viewing service, so to say. And the sound system is controlled purely via SensorML. We have Smiley, which is a SensorML editor, web-based editor, where you can edit SensorML descriptions and describe this whole process. This is sent to a control server, which deploys this complete ingestion workflow. So this complete workflow is encoded in SensorML, which also includes the description of the actual sensor. So we have kind of also the provenance, the processing steps. Everything is encoded in this one document. Every box you saw is encoded in such a little XML snippet, and this SensorML for the, what is it? Some filter which strips just a few lines from a CSV file. And it's really generic. You can write your own processors, your own event detection, quality assurance, you name it. You can put it in there and just encode it into the SensorML. And because nobody wants to write such XML snippets in a client to deploy it, this is a sync to get data into the SOS database. We enhanced our editing tool, our Smiley web service, to provide templates for use cases. For example, we have here two templates: one for MQTT sources, one for CSV files on FTP services. But we have also templates for these single processors. So you just click on, I have an MQTT source. And you fill in the URI of the MQTT server, for example, and the channel and so on. Then you have another template for a parser that can parse the messages sent through the MQTT message. And then you have a template for a database sync and so on. So you can plug these together and fill in all the information you have. This is, I think, the workflow for... This is a workflow for the MQTT source, I think, where you have an input and outputs and parameters and so on. You can fill everything in there, how the CSV is structured. And of course, you can put every metadata you have into the SensorML file. It's really generic. So in this case, we have serial numbers, model numbers, manufacturers, and so on. You can put calibration parameters in there. And these can all be used later in the analyzing part of Cdata Cloud, where I'm not part of. I don't know what you want to do with it, but many require it. And of course, we have also integrated the automatically, you can select terms from controlled vocabularies to describe your sensor in this editor. And in the end, you can display it with a generic client, in this case Helgoland. You can use any client which can access SOS services. This is displaying the observatory in front of Galway Bay of the Marine Institute in Ireland, and it is feeded, I think, with a delay of maybe 2 or 3 seconds into this viewing client, and you can display the data directly. For this is the air temperature. Here we have what do we have here. Earth relative wind speed, so we can display all data, and this client is also capable of displaying profile observations or trajectories and so on. That's it. Thank you very much.